return of the Treaty of the Fiji Interim Government to attend the 2008 Annual Pacific Islands Forum and considered this non-attendance unacceptable, and further stated that the interim government should have attended to account to forum leaders for the undertakings taken at the 2007 forum in Tonga.
We are now facing suspension from the forum, and that could be as early as next year. Fiji has been told it has to accept another visit by the Ministerial Contact Working Group later this year. Their report will be considered by leaders at a special meeting in Papua New Guinea early next year, and anything that is contrary to the Tonga commitment.
Grouping the Pacific Island Forum is being spurned in its efforts to help. So I think the Commodore needs to consider very carefully before he walks that road.
The New Zealand Prime Minister told reporters Fiji is a serious issue amongst the forum leaders, some of whom feel betrayed by the conduct of the interim PM Frank Bainimarama.
The forum needs to understand that we in Fiji will decide what is in our national interest in the short and the long term. Outsiders cannot decide this for us. What we need from the forum and our other international development partners is understanding and support. It is very well for the New Zealand Prime Minister to call for unity of the Pacific Forum on the issue of elections in Fiji. This so-called unity cannot be against Fiji, as that is neither achievable nor acceptable. Most, if not all, Pacific Island leaders are against Fiji being further victimized by Australia and New Zealand, even if they may not say so openly in any way. The unity that is not practically achievable at the forum meeting in Niue has to be one based on support for how we are now moving Fiji forward, not only towards an election, but a better and durable constitutional democracy.
Hopes that there is somewhere in that system some wise counsel that says this is serious, because the forum has never taken such a step before to say we are prepared to consider excluding this government from our councils if we can't get some proper response.
With any suspension will come the question of Fiji being the host country to...
Should such support be not forthcoming and the sanctions by Australia and New Zealand remain in effect, such actions will not affect our determination to act in our national interest.
Will trigger a suspension through several forum organizations.
The tragedy of Fiji is that it is a regional country.
In what he says about our country,
it's not an issue
with Fiji. I'm not
making any comment on Fiji.
On Fiji's failure to attend the Pacific Islands Forum Leaders Summit on account of its unwillingness to uphold the commitments given in the 2007 forum in Tonga is factually incorrect and intentionally misleading. It overlooks the fact that Fiji's intention to attend and participate fully in the forum meeting processes in Niue and in Auckland was frustrated and ultimately prevented by the news.
Public awareness about the injustice and illegality of coups and reform ethno-nationalist and religious fundamentalist institutions. But will these guarantee an end to the coup culture?
As long as you allow extreme and fundamentalist particularly ethno-nationalistic, racist-type elements to prevail, you cannot guarantee that there will be no coup. To think in terms of guarantees to be able to stop coups, I think that verges on naivety to even ask that question. It's a huge problem that Fiji has. Everybody has to look at how to make it happen, and a number of key areas have been identified, and a lot of work needs to be done.
On the need for a shared national identity.
It's been noted that in the outreach work that the NCBBF task team, the TAS, is carrying out, is an outreach program where we will get the feedback, they will get the feedback from the ordinary men and women of Fiji as to what they believe should be the way forward. Their feedback on these proposals that have been enshrined in the draft People's Charter.